I'm renewing my vow of commitment to trust you and to trust you alone. I know the natural looks real, but God, your word is more real. You are trustworthy, glory to God. You will not fail. I renew my vow of commitment to trust you. You and I have to think about how important our face-to-face encounter is with God. Where every day when you have that intimate time with God, you are renewing your vow of commitment to God to love him and love not another. Amen. That everything that you could been left or go right to or put your allegiance in, every time that you begin to have your face-to-face encounter with him, you're saying, Father, I'm renewing my vow of commitment to trust you and you alone. I don't care what it looks like in the natural. I don't care how hard this season looks. I don't care how turbulent life experience is. I'm renewing my vow of commitment to trust you and to trust you alone. I know the natural looks real, but God, your word is more real. You are trustworthy, glory to God. You will not fail. I renew my vow of commitment to trust you. It's where you renew your vow to stay holy. It's where you renew your vow to live upright. It's where you renew your vow to think right. It's where you renew your vow to talk right. Glory to God. It's where you renew your vow to walk right. Glory to God. Amen. I renew my vow. Listen, there are things that try to alter, things that try to cause us to go down another course, to think a different way. But every time I go into the presence of the holy God whom I love and serve, I have my face to face with him. He sees into me. There is no areas in my life that I can hide from him. And I have to come clean, glory to God. And I renew my vow. Will alignment. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. How did he do it? He reinforced his will in prayer. This last point here, it rings so true because he started talking to me in mechanical terms. I heard the word prayer is will alignment. And all of a sudden, I begin to see mechanically how a car gets off course when it don't have wheel alignment. Every time you and I have a face-to-face with God, every time we renew our covenant, every time we reinforce our vow and commitment, every time we have that face-to-face encounter with God, what it does is it calls will alignment. W-I-L-L. You have to understand the power of your wayward will. You got to understand the power of rebellion that's at work within you. And if you don't have daily will alignment, that's why Jesus came to the Garden of Gethsemane often. Because what was happening is he was having will alignment. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. How did he do it? He reinforced his will in prayer.
Bless you. We pray that the message has been a blessing to you. And we'd like to encourage you to continue to go to our YouTube channel and partake in these messages. We believe that each week there'll be something once again that will benefit you. And look forward to up and coming events that also may come up and flash on the message and video. We believe that the Lord will bless you richly as you continue to partake. God bless you. We love you.